Hey Catamounts, it's hard to believe that summer is pretty much behind us. Our students will be here in a few days, and it's already time for opening assembly to kick off a new year. And this is going to be an exciting one for WCU. We're welcoming our new chancellor, expecting to shatter enrollment records yet again. And this year we will be celebrating the holidays with the Pride of the Mountains marching band and the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. And speaking of celebrating, there's been a lot to celebrate for some of our Catamount alumni. Recently, I attended the wedding of two of our former students in Monaco, Louis Ducruet and Marie Chavarie. I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty teary-eyed for that experience. And speaking of teary-eyed, that was definitely the case watching WCU's own JT Poston capture his first PGA Tour win by winning the Wyndham Championship on August 4th. It's clear, our Catamounts past, future, and present are doing some amazing things. But before we look ahead to all the exciting new opportunities that come with every new school year, let's take a moment to look back and check out some of our many accomplishments from the past year.
In fall 2018, North Carolina Promise went into effect, and Western Carolina University's commitment to keeping costs affordable resulted in an overall 13% decrease in undergraduate cost of attendance. Of course, this meant that enrollment of both incoming first-year students as well as transfer students continued on its steep upward trajectory. But more than that, it meant less debt for both parents and students. It meant that Western Carolina University remains deeply committed to providing a high-quality, affordable education for anyone who wishes to pursue an undergraduate degree.
It was a stretch goal. The original goal of Lead the Way, a campaign inspired by the Belcher years, was $50 million by 2021. But the bar was raised, so the goal became $60 million, and the time frame was shortened by 2.5 years. We did it anyway. By the end of the campaign in March, we had raised almost $62 million. But it's not only about the money. It's about the 200 brand new scholarships that were created, making a college education more affordable, accessible, and attainable for so many students. For each of you who made a gift, worked on the campaign, attended an event, volunteered, or in some other way helped us to lead the way, we say thank you. Together, we changed lives.
The fall of 2018 saw the kickoff of a new bachelor's degree program in integrated health sciences designed for students who have a broad-based interest in the healthcare profession. University officials, especially Allison Morrison Shetler and Carol Burton, along with current and past deans of the graduate school and the College of Education and Allied Professions, faculty and staff throughout the psychology department and that department's task force, spent much of 2018 preparing for a new doctoral program in psychology that begins this fall. Also in 2018, research projects by WCU students were first in the state among higher education institutions having entries accepted for presentation at the prestigious National Conference on Undergraduate Research. And for the first time in over 20 years, a WCU student received a prestigious Fulbright Award. Graduate student Natalie Williams received the award to teach English in Malaysia this year.
Our student athletes made us proud last year, both athletically and in the classroom. WCU's average team semester GPA for the 2018-19 academic year was over a 3.2, and over 60% of our student athletes' GPAs came in at a 3.0 or higher. 154 Western Carolina student athletes were named on the Southern Conference Spring Honor Roll. When the National Association of Basketball Coaches announced the 7th Annual Team Academic Excellence Awards, the Catamounts were recognized by posting a team GPA of 3.285, and men's golf was honored nationally with an academic progress rate in the top 10% of men's golf programs. But our academic achievements were only the beginning. Quarterback Tyree Adams became one of only 11 NCAA FCS football players of all time to pass for over 2,000 yards and rush for over 1,000 yards in the same season, while becoming WCU's all-time leader with 53 career touchdown passes, and he was a second-team All-America selection. Men's track and field won the Southern Conference Championships in both the indoor and outdoor championships. This made the sixth consecutive championship for indoor track and the fourth consecutive for outdoor track. Caitlin Lingard set the school record in the women's 10K cross-country distance, and women's tennis had a record-setting season with 12 wins.
2018 was an excellent year for the Catamount Club. It was our third straight year receiving cash gifts that totaled over $2 million, and it made it 11 years running that we broke the previous year's scholarship fundraising campaign, coming in 2018 at nearly $1.7 million in student-athlete scholarship support. To top it off, we acquired 7 new accounts at our new legacy level of giving, each contributing $50,000 or more annually.
2018 also marked the 50th anniversary of the Catamount Club, celebrating 50 years of philanthropic fundraising for WCU athletics. Our goal was to have 500 new or existing donors increase their gift by $50, but we actually had over 650 donors join or make the increase. And we received a $50,000 challenge gift from former WCU student athlete Tad Gretton. An awesome year for the Catamount Club and even better for our student athletes.
Western Carolina University founded the Outdoor Economy Conference in fall 2018 with a focus on serving and connecting all of the people and organizations who make up the broader outdoor economy, including outdoor organizations, economic developers, and area local governments. The conference sold out with over 250 attendees in 2018, so this year we're expanding and anticipate over 750 people this October.
Last year, WCU began construction on the Apodaca Science Building, a 6-story structure housing laboratory, classroom, assembly, and office space, and a rooftop plaza for astronomy observations. New construction also began to remodel and modernize the ground floor at HF Robinson to house admissions, whose staff will be relocating from the camp building later this fall.
The IT department completed improvements on telecommunication infrastructure with new fiber optic and copper cables, along with 3 new telco huts to improve the resiliency of campus telecom infrastructure. It will also enable future capabilities not possible with the existing environment. And to help accommodate the university's continued growth, a 420-space parking lot was completed near Judicola Hall, a new overflow parking lot was constructed near the print shop, and a new 600-bed residence hall was completed on upper campus.
On September 7th last year, WCU's Board of Trustees voted to name the new 600-bed Upper Campus Residence Hall in honor of Laverne Hamlin Allen. In 1957, Laverne was the first African-American student to enroll at WCU and among the first to be admitted to any of North Carolina's all-white state colleges. She went on to serve 2 terms on the WCU's Board of Trustees from 1987 into 1995, and she was also selected to receive an honorary doctorate of humane letters in 2006. The Upper Campus Residence Hall is the first building on campus to be named after an African-American member of the WCU community. And on September 5th, Ms. Allen will return to Western Carolina University for the dedication of Laverne Hamlin Allen Hall.
In April, WCU successfully hosted the inaugural Southeastern Latinx Student Leadership Conference. It was the first conference of this kind in the region and was presented by the Latino Appreciation Student Organization with the support from the Office of Equal Opportunity and Diversity Programs. The goal of the conference was to empower student identity for the Latinx community, encouraging them to own their experience in college, to claim their space, and to feel like they belong. 175 participants attended the conference from across the region, and planning for next year's conference is already underway.
Probably one of the most exciting things to happen last year was the election of Western Carolina's 12th chancellor, Dr. Kelly Brown. The Catamount community was bubbling over with interest and anticipation when the initial announcement hit. It was all hands on deck as faculty, staff, and even students stepped forward to help welcome her to campus. None of it would have happened, though, without the diligent efforts of the Chancellor's Search Committee, on which many of our faculty, staff, and alumni sat. We are ultimately grateful for their efforts in bringing us our new chancellor.
Well, there you have it. What a year. And those were just the highlights. We'd be watching a full-length feature film if we talked about every single thing we did as a university in 2018. But the point is, we did some pretty great stuff, and we did it for the benefit of our students and our community and for each other. We did it because Western Carolina is a beacon of excellence, and we take pride in that. We did it because we are Catamounts. Go Cats!